Welcome to the first video in a new week of this Micro Masters course. In this week, we are going to study on how to design a PV system. In today's video, we will briefly go through the different components that are available in the PV system. This is followed by a short discussion on the different types of PV systems, and finally, we will conclude by introducing the different methodologies that are available in order to perform a PV system design. As seen in the previous weeks, PV systems comprise PV panels, balance of system components such as the charge controller, inverter, battery, cables, converters, mounting frames, and the outputs. In particular, we have learned in detail how the different components in the PV system operate with respect to one another. Basically, depending on the application, we have to use these components to design and build a complete PV system. And there are different types of PV systems. They can be classified in standalone PV systems and the grid-connected PV systems. Each of these categories might be further subdivided into several subcategories. A standalone PV system relies only on solar power, since it is not connected to the distribution grid. It contains a storage system, such as batteries, to store the unused solar energy. Standalone PV systems are usually installed in remote areas where the grid is absent. Typical components in a standalone PV system include the PV panels, loads both DC and AC type, inverter that connects to the AC loads, and the charge controllers. On the other hand, grid-connected PV systems have the distribution grid as a backup and are typically installed in buildings. They consist of the PV panels, the loads, and the inverter that connects the AC loads and the PV panels. Now it is time to look at how all the components are designed and brought together to create a complete PV system. We can design a PV system at different levels of complexity. Based on time and the other resources available, there are two design strategies that can be employed. The first is the simple design strategy of a PV system. The simple design strategy is based on very simple assumptions and does not take any weather-dependent changes into account. It is quick and easy to work with and can be executed using a simple spreadsheet application. In such a design approach, the performance of the PV modules and of the other components are determined by considering only their standard test conditions, values, and the equivalent sun hours at the system's location. This strategy is normally used to create a first approximation of a PV system design. The second type of design is the complex one. After a first approximation of the design obtained from the previous strategy, a detailed analysis of the PV system performance can be carried out using this second design strategy. In this respect, the location-dependent variable irradiance and weather conditions, the profile of the loads and other inputs are used to obtain time-dependent performance characteristics of the PV system. To this end, we are going to put together all models, tools, and steps learned in previous weeks of this course. By using this strategy, a PV system design close to the reality can be achieved, albeit, to execute it, a programming language such as MATLAB needs to be used. To conclude, in this week you are going to learn about simple and complex design strategies. You will learn how to implement these strategies for both standalone PV system and grid-connected PV system. In the next video, we will begin with the simple design strategy.